Hi, and welcome to another fun and fact-filled half hour of The Wedding Experts. I'm Andrea Ventress, Deputy Editor of Wedding Magazine, and together with my team of experts, we're here to solve all your modern-day bridal dilemmas. Coming up on the show, we meet a bride-to-be who has no clue when it comes to styles of wedding photography, with industry heavyweight Keith Appleby will point her in the right direction. Plus, busting a move in your wedding dress. Just what to do with that elusive first dance to wow your guests. We'll have hot tips aplenty with Strictly Come Dancing star Karen Hardy. Joining me in the studio is bride-to-be Suzanne Ashley. Hi, Suzanne.
Hi.
So tell me a little bit about your wedding and your dilemma.
Well, I'm getting married in September this year, and I've really been struggling with photography. My family wants some formal shots, but we really like something a bit more off the cuff and informal. And I just don't know what to do or where to start.
Okay, well, I'm sure we can help. We've got top wedding photographer Keith Appleby, and I met him recently, and here's a montage of some of his best work.
My name is Keith Appleby, and I'm from Keith Appleby Photography. I started out as a photographer from a very early age, and I always knew I wanted to be a photographer. I trained originally as a fashion photographer, and later on moved into product and lifestyle. And this actually gave me a good grounding in all three areas of the photographic world, and eventually I built up one of Europe's biggest photographic studios. And it was actually my wife, about 4 years ago, who saw this opportunity. And then I switched to shooting weddings in that style, and I never looked back. Even though I'm a reportage photographer, and most of the time I follow the action as it happens, I don't normally stage manage most things in a wedding, but there are one or two occasions during a wedding when I have to orchestrate a few pictures. Otherwise, nothing would happen, particularly family group shots and solo shots of the couple just walking down, you know, at me. Because if I didn't do that, we wouldn't have any shots at all. And even if you have the odd couple who say, I want it totally reportage, if you do it totally reportage and you do no family group shots or anything, somebody will be disappointed, particularly the mothers, the grandmothers. They'll say, why haven't you done a family shot? So I do orchestrate those shots.
For looking at all those wedding pictures. Keith, thank you so much for joining us today. You're one of Wedding Magazine's favourite wedding photographers. Your style of photography is reportage. Can you explain that a bit for us?
Well, reportage is truthfully about documenting your day. It came from reportage war photography originally. In fact, weddings are a little bit like a war sometimes, but I call them a friendly fire zone, so I quite enjoy it. Really, it's about documenting your entire day from start to finish, and the reportage style is about following every bit of action as it happens. There are documentary and reportage photographers who feel that just by sticking a wide-angle lens on a camera, they could just go around and get a sort of abstract kind of rough and ready, almost like war pictures of your wedding day. And you might like this, you know, but I think that the best reportage photographers are those who can see the beautiful parts of the day as well as capturing the action. So it won't just be reportage with a wide angle. They'll be following you, but they'll be looking for your best angle and your guest's best angle. And they'll also be trying to find a bit of humour in the day because there's lots of fun things at weddings. And personally, you know, I like looking for humour all day long. You can't always find it. There's a lot of tension, a lot of, you know, like, well, I'm getting married, you know. But actually, once once you've actually committed and you've done your rings, it all kind of relaxes after that.
Do you have any tips for loosening your brides up so that they don't look like they're so nervous?
Well, a glass of champagne while you're getting your makeup on and your hair is a must, quite frankly, unless you don't like alcohol at all. And I would just keep breathing sensibly and think about, you know, just enjoying the thing. You know, don't get hyped up. The whole thing about a wedding is you spend this whole year, 18 months, about, you know, finding weddings, cakes, photographers, flowers, whatever it is, and every little detail takes you forever. And then suddenly you're there. The day's it's like having an Oscar night, you know. And really, it's just like, this is your day, enjoy it. Don't get nervy about it, because you're marrying someone you love, you know him. Most people live with their fiancés these days. It's a tiny fraction, you don't. So it's really about performing. You kind of feel you are performing in front of everyone. I think that's the scariest bit. Like, how will I walk down the aisle? You know, is the dress absolutely 100%? Well, you know, it doesn't matter if it's a couple of things not quite right. You walk down, it's gone in a flash.
As long as you're happy, that'll come across in your pictures.
If you're happy, yeah.
So is it quite normal for photographers to arrive very, very early on in the day and then stay right to the end?
Well, yes. I wouldn't say very, very early. I personally arrive a couple of hours before the wedding ceremony. I don't spend a lot of time, masses of time, getting in your hair curlers and with no makeup or anything, because you won't really want those shots as memories. But photographers, yes, typically a couple of hours beforehand, and some just go up to the first dance. More and more of us are staying because I personally find the dancing shots are quite fun. They're hard to get. Yes. Because people are moving around, but usually I do a good hour or two of dancing these days. And obviously if you're having a special send-off at night, I mean, some people finish with fireworks or whatever it is, then you have to stay for that. Or if you're throwing the bouquet at midnight, if you're throwing a bouquet, you might not be.
A lot of brides don't nowadays, I think.
So it's about getting the whole day in. Yeah. But photographers do different packages. You know, some will do an 8-hour thing or a 5-hour. So each photographer will have his certain way of laying out his prices and his hours.
So how important is it to get those more traditional group shots?
It's very important to have formal shots. They don't have to be traditional. I call them structured shots. In other words, it's the one part of the day when you're going to put a bit of structure into the photography. And the idea really is that all your nearest and dearest are actually captured, because you might not get them all candidly. So you make a point of allotting maybe 15 or 20 minutes, which is what most brides today don't want. Masses of time spent on formal shots, because you want to get back to your guests, back to your wedding. And the biggest fear is, will the photographer take an hour over formal shots? Because we've all been to weddings where the bride and groom disappear with a family, and, you know, 30 or 40 people march off somewhere by a river or wherever they're going. Yeah, they might fall in if they're unlucky, and they spend hours, sort of, you know, maybe an hour doing this. And my advice is that yes, they're important, and it's important to get good, happy pictures of everyone enjoying the day. And your photographer will engage you and make sure that you're mainly smiling and having a good time. This will come across in pictures. If you see formal shots where everyone's a bit sort of like that, that is not good traditional photography. Years ago, that's what you got. You got everyone just standing there like that, you know. Today, most photographers, you know, it's about their personality and making you guys sort of, you know, relax in front of the camera.
So obviously, finding the photographer who's got the right style for you is key. Just one more thing, Keith. When can you expect to get your wedding photos?
Well, you should get them when you come back from honeymoon, in terms of hard copies. But most photographers today put them on a password-protected website. So this means that while you're lying on a beach somewhere with your toes in the water or whatever, with your laptop beside you, you can actually look at your wedding from anywhere in the world. And this is really what most of us are doing now, and that's really the best way of just at least pinching yourself and saying, yeah, actually my wedding actually happened. That was me having a silly time or whatever. And so you get to see the pictures rather quickly today. We live in a world of fast stuff, and it would be a bit odd if you had to wait 3 or 4 weeks these days. The hard copies you would expect to have back when you come back from honeymoon. Then if you're having an album or a storybook, this has to be developed over the next few months, or sometimes a year, depending on how quick you are and how quick the photographer is on putting it all together.
Fantastic. Well, lots of great information there, Keith. Thank you so much. Thank you very much, Suzanne. I hope we've helped.
Yes, absolutely.
Still to come on The Wedding Experts, Strictly Come Dancing star Karen Hardy gives us plenty of tips on that all-important first dance. See you then. Welcome back from the break. Joining me now is bride-to-be Laura Kinnard. Hi Laura, how are you doing?
I'm very well, thank you.
Thank you very much for joining us on The Wedding Experts. Now, I hear you've got a bit of a problem about the first dance. A little bit concerned about taking to the dance floor.
Yes, that's right. I love dancing and I'd really love to put a few steps into our first dance, make it a little bit exciting for all our guests.
And how does your groom-to-be feel about this?
He's not too happy. He's not really a dancer himself. He's more likely to be propped up against the bar. But I'm going to make him for this part of the wedding is going to be my bit, and I want to definitely get him to do a few steps on the dance floor.
Well, we've got the most amazing expert lined up for you now. It's Strictly Come Dancing Series 4 winner, Karen Hardy. You went down to her recently opened dance studio. Let's see how you got on.
I'm Karen Hardy, and together with my husband, we are the new owners of a very beautiful dance studio here in Chelsea in London. The idea is to make dancing cool, exciting, and a lot of fun. Not only for women, we want the men to come down, which is why we specialise a great deal in wedding parties for brides and grooms, and of course, most importantly, the wedding dance for the bride and groom themselves. What's happening today? We've got the lovely Laura coming to the studio for the first time, and the idea is I'm going to just show her how easy it is to actually dance. Most wedding couples believe they can't do it. I'm going to show them so easy, a couple of steps, and they'll be whizzing around the dance floor. Let Peter and I show you what you're going to do first, okay? Very, very simple. It's designed with two forward walks, a side and a together. So literally, two forward walks, walk, walk, a step to the side, close your feet together.
I really wanted a wedding dance lesson just because I don't want to do the wedding shuffle. Don't want to just stand there when we play our song and just, you know, move around the dance floor like that. So I really want to put just a couple of moves into it for me and my fiance.
Walk, walk, side, and together. Don't panic. And walk forward again. Walk, walk, side, together. The most common problem of all when it comes to their first ever wedding dance is there's this fear that they can't do it. Now, once we overcome that, the things that people want to do is incredible. But number one, it's overcoming the fear. Keep the hands nice and soft. Enjoy yourself, and Peter will guide you through the dance floor, okay? Here we go. And walk, walk, and side together. Walk, walk, and side together. She's worried about her feet, I can feel it. I don't want to tread on his toes. One of the big problems is the guy, the groom. It's a nightmare, but I say to them always, what's the point of having a Ferrari in your garage and not driving it?
My husband-to-be's worry is making a fool of himself, embarrassing himself in front of all his mates, just generally looking a bit stupid, I suppose.
Okay, you have to be very careful when you're doing your wedding dance, because obviously if you've got a full ball gown, we're limited with some of the steps that you can do. Come back up here with me, let me show you. Now, where you had the walk, walk, side together, walk, walk, side together, then you went into promenade.
Yep.
The gentleman will keep doing the same steps, and instead of going into promenade, you're just going to turn gently under his arm, okay? So it'll go like this. And walk, walk, side together. Walk, walk, side together. Under the arm, under the arm, under the arm, and side together. Owing to there being this big demand on television for dance now, and everybody's excited to dance again, everybody wants to do this wedding dance now. Okay, it's called a fishtail. So we turn in. We take the leg, up and down. What's amazing is that it's not just a soft and gentle Frank Sinatra. We've got rock and roll numbers, we've got Argentinian tango numbers that people want to do. They want to do the big lifts from Dirty Dancing and things like that. Let's go from the explosions. So you're out there to the side, take her out to the side, good boy. Lovely, all right, now. Turn in so you're backing, good, good girl, lovely, stop right there. Now, here we go. So you take back your left leg. Now don't drop your body, don't drop, tone up, that's it. Good, are you ready? Here we go. Hop, and down, and back up again. Okay, now, that didn't quite look like a fishtail, did it?
It was really good fun. I didn't realise how romantic that kind of dancing is. I really enjoyed it. Really wish my fiancé could have been here today to learn the steps, but I'm definitely going to put it into practice when I get home.
Okay, well, Laura, there we go. It was a fast, quick lesson, but we showed you, firstly, how to just get around the dance floor, most important. For the first little wow moment, a couple of twirls, and we're showing off your wedding dress. Then we went into the most romantic thing of all, which is the dip. And your husband can give you a little kiss on the cheek if he wants to. Most importantly, have a great time and enjoy yourself on the night. Great. All right,
thank
my
dad. So
lovely
much.
To meet you.
Take care.
All right.
Thank you.
Let's take you back to the lounge.
Well, Laura, that was great. You're amazing. I love that lift. Hi, Karen. Thanks so much for joining us in the studio.
Thank you.
Now, before we get started on Laura's first dance, I can't have you in here without asking about Strictly Come Dancing. Obviously, it's so, so popular at the moment. Are you noticing this massive craze now in first dances?
There is a massive craze. And I think it's for a simple reason. There's so much doom and gloom out there now. The one place that people can escape to is on the dance floor. And where better than on your wedding dance? You know, wedding dance evening, your 2 minutes moment, everybody's watching you, and people are really, they're flocking into the studios now. I want to have a go. I want to do those lifts that I saw on Strictly, you know, so it's incredible.
What do you think about, have you seen anything on YouTube when they've done like the dirty dancing or even the thriller thing? Have you seen that?
It's quite frightening what people are really doing now with these wedding dances. I find it exciting because I think, great, people are out there, so still have a lot of fun.
Yeah.
But some of the lengths they're going to, I heard there's a Michael Jackson thriller movie,
yes.
And I think the whole bridal party are getting involved now. Why not? Bring it in. Let's have some happiness, and I love it.
But are you seeing mostly bride and grooms coming in for help?
In our studio at the moment, it's still only being the bride and groom, but they're beginning to get a little bit adventurous. We've just had one recently. They want to start with a cha-cha and then develop into an Argentine tango.
Wow.
Now, most people would have come in and said, I'm really nervous, I'd just like to do a little dance around the floor. This couple come in and said, no, here's the music, these are the two dances we'd like to do, we'd like a few lifts in it, and, you know, costume advice would be great.
Oh, my God.
And I'm thinking, my God, where is the little social foxtrot gone? But it's exciting.
So they're going for full-on routines. They're not just learning how to move.
Yeah, it's not about just moving around the dance floor. I think because they've seen so much fun on all these television shows. And you can't hide on a reality television show. It's genuine fun.
Yeah.
And I think that's, you know, the wedding experience can get very stressful.
Yeah.
You've got all the family involved. And what I say to the people when they come to our studio is, you know, come along. Just have a little bit of escapism for 1 hour, 5 hours, however much time you've got. And they really are enjoying themselves, so much so it's frightening what they want to do.
So how many lessons would you recommend then for a first dance?
I generally say for a first dance, 1 to 5 lessons.
Mm-hmm.
1 hour will just help you to get around the dance floor. There's nothing worse, as I think Laura said earlier, than doing the wedding shuffle.
Yes.
They just stand there, you've got about 250 people watching you, and you're rocking side to side, you're really embarrassed, and you know at some point you're gonna kiss each other, and the whole room's gonna go, oh! You know, people want to be entertained. They've gone there to really have a great night, and it's a lot of pressure on the wedding couple. Well, it's up to about 3 hours. You can get around the dance floor, you can do a little bit of, like we saw in the VT there, a couple of little drops. About 5 hours, you can do anything you like. You can supply your own music. You can be baby that does the lift with Patrick Swayze and up you go. But obviously, security, health and safety, all that needs to be explained if anybody's going to try it at home.
Yeah, absolutely. We've also seen this new craze for marioki. Have you heard this? No,
marioki. Tell me more.
I think it's about sort of singing and dancing, the whole shebang, as you said, with the costumes. Maybe that would be a new trend. Do you think you'd quite enjoy getting involved in that?
What's coming through the door frightens me at the moment, but why not? Bring it on. And, you know, singing again, it's that feel-good factor. People
yeah.
just would like the feel-good factor. And that's the great thing about dancing, full stop. And that's what we're seeing coming through the studio now. It doesn't even have to be a wedding. People just want an hour's entertainment and fun. Dance, singing brings it all to you.
So you got married yourself about 2 years ago, didn't you? What did you do for your first dance?
Okay, I'm a little bit embarrassed about my first dance because our wedding was in Santorini, on an island, 7:30 at night, fireworks, all really romantic, took a lot of organising. And it wasn't until the night my husband and I said, we haven't organised our wedding dance. So thank goodness. I mean, luckily my husband is a champion in dance himself. I am. So we're in a position that we could have a lot of fun out there. We chose Hero, because my husband's my hero,
aww,
by Enrique Iglesias. And at the end, it was beautiful. We went into a little dip, and a big number of the guys actually had secretly coloured in these numbers. So they held it up like like they were strictly on the skating system. And it was great. It was absolutely brilliant. It was great fun. But one tip there already I give to everybody. First of all, always check what the words are on your song that you've chosen. And I had an example just the other week. I was teaching a couple how to get around the dance floor. And this lady said to me, oh gosh, if ever I get married, that's the song I would love. And I said, did you listen to the words? And she goes, no, it was Frank Sinatra. Fantastic. My Lady is a Tramp. So I've got to say, the first thing, check the words that are on the song that you love.
Well, Laura, what have you got? Have you got a song picked out?
Yeah, Just Too Good to Be True by Andy Williams, isn't
okay.
it?
Okay, I think that's quite a traditional
one. It starts
one.
Off quite slow and then gets a bit faster, so we're hoping it'll be a bit more, sort of people will join us when it gets a bit faster.
So Karen, can you give us a bit of advice? Laura's groom-to-be was a little bit embarrassed and didn't want to come to the lesson. How can that work if it's just the bride-to-be going to have the lessons?
What we'd do there, if it was just the bride-to-be, we would give her, as we did to you, Laura, we gave you a couple of the basic moves, didn't we? And with something like that, what the groom will do are the exact opposite steps to what Laura would have had to have done. So she could have gone home and said, yes, I had a great time, come on, have a go. And those steps you can do in your lounge, I think you'd see.
And obviously it's very important to practice after the lessons.
Yeah, practicing, be warned. It can be a moment of a divorce before you've even got down the aisle. So be a little bit acceptable to each other. Men do learn initially slightly slower than women when it comes to dancing.
Right.
Women, take a deep breath, help your men through the first couple of steps because it's their ego that's being attacked. Mm. You know, why can't I dance and my wife can? I should be able to lead my lady around the dance floor. So deal with their egos a little bit. Help them a little bit, let them struggle, but just make them feel at ease. Because once they've got it, there's nothing greater than a man leading you around the dance floor.
Lots of great advice. Thanks so much, Karen, for joining us in the studio. And Laura, lots of luck with your first dance. Hope it goes well. That's all we've got time for in today's show. I hope we've given you plenty of red-hot advice for your photography and first dance. Next time, it's venues and honeymoons. So if you need any help with those areas, just call the wedding experts. Bye for now.